Hey, I'm Don Sackett, CEO, co-founder of PsyApps, and I'm here with my chief scientist. We always like to wear matching clothes. My chief scientist, Brendan Connors, who invented our lead paint algorithm that we're using in this XRF. So we're here at this old church in beautiful fall day in Massachusetts, just to do a little field testing, talk a little bit about this analyzer, and rebuke what some of the competition is saying about it. So anyway, first of all, as you may know, we introduced this lead paint analyzer about 6 or 7 months ago. It's an X-ray tube system. What that means is there's no radioactive isotopes in it. It uses an X-ray tube, which is an electric current means of generating X-rays. We then went out, we got a PCS from HUD and EPA at action levels of 10, 0.7, and 0.5. It's a perfect PCS at all three. There's no inconclusive tests. There's no substrates. And the average testing times are the fastest of any lead paint analyzer on the market. And some of the best things about this device, now that it has a PCS, is you don't have to worry about those radioactive isotopes anymore. That means several things for your business. First of all, it means a lot of those licensing headaches and travel restrictions go away. You can take the device home in the evening. You can keep it in your car. You don't have to worry about it getting stolen from a point of view of a radioactive isotope on the loose. You don't have those resourcing costs. So this system is guaranteed for 5 years, meaning you will never have to replace a source, the X-ray tube, for 5 years, and you'll never lose speed. This thing is as fast the day you get it as it will be in 5 years. And so you got a lot of cost savings there. And finally, just the overall, you know, safety idea of you don't have to be walking into homes and schools with a radioactive isotope. So it's been a great system. It's been really successful on the marketplace. And we're really, really pleased with it. And good job here to Brendan, who did such a nice, such good work on developing this whole algorithm.
Well, thank you.
All right, you're welcome. And I'll get you a new coat just for your reward for that. Anyway, so the other thing we want to do is talk a little bit about what the competition is saying about this device. At maybe a recent conference, for example, where they showed some silly science experiment they did. Competition's trying to convince you that this kind of a device won't work. They say it only does surface lead. So that's why we came out to this 300-year-old church to do some quick shots and show you otherwise. Now let's first talk about why the competition is making these comments. First, if this device did not do buried lead, there is no way it would have gotten a PCS. One of the reasons the EPA and HUD came out with the PCS testing protocol was so that you, the end user, doesn't have to be a scientist and try to decipher all the claims and statements made by XRF manufacturers. So they created this archive of several hundred real-world paint samples from all over the country. And if you want to sell a device for lead testing, you have to send the devices to this facility. We don't go. The people at the facility run the device through all the samples and they generate a PCS. So we know for a fact that there's many, many thickly painted samples on those devices, over at these archives. And so we know that since it's got a good PCS, it's got to work great on buried lead. So the question is, why is the competition trying to say this about this new technology? And look, it's simple. They make a lot of money selling you isotope replacements. All right, it's like the razor blade business, except for really, really expensive razor blades. So they make good money about every, say, 18 months, because the half-life of that cobalt 57 isotope is about 9 months. Most people replace it within two half-lives, so 18 months. So they make a lot of good money on charging you for source replacements every year and a half. It's a great business model. The problem is with the X-ray tube technology, that's now obsolete. Nobody wants to pay over and over for radioactive materials when they can buy a system that doesn't have any radioactive materials that they don't have to replace for at least 5 years. And the device will never lose speed over that whole period of time. So that's why this is a real huge advantage. It's really disrupted that whole isotope market. And quite honestly, nobody wants isotopes now if they don't need them. Now that this guy is available without isotopes. So that's why. So they're saying these crazy things. Don't believe it. Call us. Talk to HUD. Talk to EPA. Look at the PCS. Again, the reason the PCS methodology was brought out was so you, the customer, doesn't have to be a scientist to figure out all these different manufacturers' claims. If the device has a good PCS, you can use it, as long as you follow the PCS. And this has a great PCS at all three action levels you see around the country. 1.0 at the federal level, 0.7, which you see in South Carolina, Maryland, a few other places, I think Milwaukee, and then 0.5, which you see in like New York City. Great device, works great, has PCSs, no radioactive sources. So let's just do a few shots while we're here at this old church. In and show how this thick, cracking paint looks. Let's take this spot, let's see what we got here. So, this will be one of your longer tests because the lead level is very close to the action level and the depth factor, which we'll explain in a second, is about 5. So this is reading 1468, and look at that. It came out as a positive 1.07 milligrams, so it's positive compared to the 1.0 federal standard. Now that 5-point-something depth factor, that's an indication that the lead is underneath many, many layers of non-lead paint. There's not a direct mathematical relationship, but just based on our experience, that's probably at least 10 or 15, maybe 20 coats of paint on top of the lead paint. So that's a great example of lead right around the action level and a high depth. And that test was probably 5-6 seconds. The reason it was that long was because the lead is so close to the action level, you need to have really good precision to make sure it's above or below 1. And as you know with XRF guns, the longer you test, the better the precision. So there's some other spots. Let's try this spot up here. Here's some other paint. This is another good one. Again, this is going to be one of the longer tests. This is about a 4-second test. This is test 1469. You see, the lead is here is a little lower. And if you look here, you can see it looks like it's a little newer material. It's only about 0.4, and it doesn't have nearly the depth, so there's less paint, and that just visually you can see that from here. So again, those are kind of your longer tests because they're closer to the action level and they're in its thick paint. See this right here? See how cracked and thick that is right there? Mm-hmm. All right, let's take a couple shots there, right on that thick stuff. Now that was a really fast test. That was test 1470. That was really fast because the lead is high. It's up almost 5. That was like a 1 or 2 second test. Very thick paint though. That depth factor of 10, that's probably 50 or more coats of paint. Again, what we're showing here is this thing gives good, accurate results on real world paint, just like the PCS test. Now let's do something along this baseboard, for example. Here's a spot we can test. The other thing about this device, it's got a nice long narrow snout, so you can fit it into window sills and window jams and into those friction surfaces that you have to test when you're doing a lead inspection. So that's a nice feature of it. People really like that. Let's hear another spot. So again, this is going to be a longer test because the lead is so close to the action level. It's not quite as deep, but that took almost 5 or 6 seconds because this is test 1471. You can see the lead was almost right around 1, depth value about 3. The other thing I want to show you about this device, you'll notice if you look at the isotope base units, they all have a sensor down here. And the reason for that sensor is that's required by law. It makes sure the device is pushed up against a surface before you can turn the X-rays on. For the X-ray tube device, we don't need that sensor, which makes it a lot easier to do rounded or curved surfaces. It still has a great safety feature. For example, if you try to just shoot this thing, like if I try to shoot this at my chief scientist, which I wouldn't want to do because then he won't invent any more cool stuff. But if I try to shoot this at my chief scientist, what happens is it sees there's no x-rays coming back and it says no sample detected and it automatically shuts off the x-rays. So you can't just shoot this thing into air even though there's no hardware type of sensor there. A great feature, like I said, doing railings and curved surfaces, irregular surfaces, that's a lot easier with this device because you're not required to have that physical sensor there. Good. Let's try this spot right here. Again, we're going for the thickest possible paint. That was a very fast test. You see, it was 1 second. Do it again. 1 second test, 1473. Again, it was very fast because the lead is up around 5. But look at the depth, almost 17 depth factor. That's probably 75, 100 layers of paint. So again, really thick paint, no problem with this reader. And we wouldn't expect any problems because it's got a great PCS. Yes, just to wrap this quick video up, as we were saying, great PCS. So you don't have to worry about all this fake news out there about surface lead versus non-surface lead. And it's got a great PCS. No radioactive isotopes, no costly source replacements, all that licensing headaches, those go away. Easy to travel with the device, easy to take it across state lines. We hope you give this thing a test drive before you buy your next lead paint detector. We've had a lot of success with it. Most states, counties, cities that are buying new instruments are buying this one because they don't want all that ownership cost of those isotopes and those headaches. So give it a shot. Thank you very much.